I think your only remaining impediment to seeing and driving the car. So kind of briefly take you through kind of the current landscape, the positioning of the car, sort of our pre-launch activities that we've been doing for the last couple months. And at the end, if you're really nice, we'll talk about pricing also. So this is the buyer profile for the coupe, and this is really the numbers for our current coupe, but it gives you a good feel for how the segment plays out and how the we stack up against the competitive models. The real change we see on the new generation product is we're going to go from approximately a 70% male buyer to 60%. So we do see a 40% female buyer for this product, which puts us kind of in the midpoint where BMW and Mercedes-Benz are. The other thing to note is that we do skew much younger than the other competitive products, and because of that, we've got more folks in the what we call the pre-family stage of life, which is less than 45 with no kids. Next slide, please. This is the segment, and it's this is obviously a very sexy segment, but it's not a huge segment. And the chart clearly shows how it's dropped off in recent years, but. Combined with the launch of the new 3 Series last year, our launch this year, and what we expect out of Lexus in the next 9 to 12 months, we do see the segment rebounding back to its prior level and leveling off. So we do feel we're launching this product at a great time. We were the segment leader for most of the prior generation's life, and our goal is to get back to that point. In terms of our transition plan, Kyle mentioned earlier with our 2006 sales, we did not want to play the incentive game with the current product line. We did not want to have a kind of a glut of inventory of the current product line. So we did a good job of managing our inventories to make sure we had a real smooth transition to sell the 08. So when we launch the next month on August 21st, we're going to have a very low day supply of the current product, and we'll start sales immediately and start running with it. So what have we done to make this transition? We took a lot of steps with the dealers. Number one was we gave them a lot of tools early on, much earlier on in the process, in terms of ordering the product. We gave them a lot of product knowledge up front. We provided a lot of showroom materials. We're going to provide pricing about 3 weeks in advance of the launch. Normally, we announce pricing pretty much when we launch the car. So we're going to give them about 3 weeks to have the pricing out there to kind of close the loop with current customers. And we're also doing a nationwide training program where every dealership in the country will be visited with a coupe and with a 3 Series BMW. And they'll do a real dynamic ride and drive with all the sales consultants in each of the stores. So when the car hits the showroom floor, the sales consultants will be well trained, they'll understand the car, and they'll understand the competition. And the last thing we're doing is we're sending what we call a consignment unit, which is is one car to every dealership, which they should arrive in about 10 days. And they'll have that car for a number of reasons, for display purposes, to kind of preview with some customers, to further train their employees. The big reason is it's to facilitate a national launch event night on August 16th. So every dealership will have that one car. They'll invite their customer base to the dealership. They'll have, it'll be nice wine, cheese, jazz quartet type deal, and show the car to their customer base. So in your local markets, you may hear about these, you may get invited to one, but please take advantage of it to kind of get to kind of see what the customers are seeing about the car. In terms of marketing communications plan, we had a wide range of activities, interactive marketing, direct marketing to our customers. I'm sure a lot of you have seen the print that we've been running so far and a lot of the buff books. And also, we did some cool things with our website, which I'll talk about next. In terms of the ordering, I mentioned that earlier. Normally, we spec the cars out from the start of production. Normally, we just build the cars, and we allocate them to the dealers based on a fair share allotment. This time, we let the dealers build the cars from day one. So they were allotted so many cars, we let them configure the cars to their needs from day one instead of us doing it for them. We did that for a couple reasons. Number one, they've been selling coupes the last 5 years. They're good at it, they know the marketplace, and we wanted them to have visibility of all the cars up front. Number two, there's a lot of similarities between the current sedan and the new coupe, so they already know kind of a lot of things about the product also. And number three, there's so much buzz about this car, we knew that there were customers already coming in months ago saying, hey, when that coupe comes in, I want a black one with the following packages on it. So we want to give the dealers the flexibility to actually order those cars up front for those customers. The microsite I mentioned earlier, what we did there was, on our website, we allow customers to kind of loosely configure a car, color, model, option packages. We transmit that information to the dealerships, and the dealers can then follow up with the customers and say, hey, guess what, we've got that exact car coming in September. So kind of closing the loop on pre-sale with that program. All these activities have kind of led to hundreds of customers coming in early and making deposits on the cars. They haven't seen the car. They don't know what the pricing is. They've still come in, reserved a car, placed deposits as high as $1,500, the highest one I've seen. But they're definitely putting their money down on this car already. So when we launched on August 21st, those cars are pre-sold. So it's going to be a little bit of a wait for someone who walks in cold on August 21st and wants to buy a car. Let me read this to you. This is kind of the positioning of the car. Later on while you're driving, if you want to just kind of repeat this slowly to yourself to remind yourself of what you're experiencing, this is the pure seductive expression of intense performance. It's called our strategic handle. I know it's a little ethereal, but that's kind of where we start with the car. This kind of defines the product. The key words being kind of the seduction, the intensity, and the performance. And we feel this kind of aligns well with the purchase reasons in this segment, which are fun to drive and real nice styling of the product line. That's what folks are looking for in this car. And when you see our advertising next month, it's really going to be aligned well with this positioning, because it's a lot of intense reds, a lot of really cool light effects, and really highlighting the performance of the car. Who's our marketing target? And you know, this is aspirational. You know, we understand, and you saw earlier when I said our average age of our buyer is 47 years old. So although we are targeting a buyer who's in their early 30s, we understand there's a lot of folks in their 50s who are going to buy this car also. It's kind of one of those cars that reaches people in a lot of life stages. We see a lot of 25-year-old kids coming in, and we see a lot of empty nesters and retirees coming in buy the car also. It's kind of a fun car in their retirement. So. But the passionate performance seekers that we're targeting tend to be in their early 30s, they're married, they don't have kids, they do skew towards the male side a little bit, college grads, professional people. They tend to be metropolitan people, good balance between work and social life. They enjoy all kinds of activities, sports, social activities. Their values are, they seek things that provide a real strong emotional response. This is a very emotional segment, and they want to have experiences that provide that, that back that up. They value creativity and design, which we feel we're really hitting the target with this car. They drive coupes. A lot of them don't even cross shop anything else, and this is what they kind of define themselves as, is a coupe driver, a performance car driver. And it's really kind of an extension of their personality. And a personal reward for them. So again, this target, the product itself, really aligns well with the appeal of the car, which is the exhilarating performance, the stunningly seductive styling, and the modern luxurious interior.